Hello everybody, this is Fernando for the latest Cryptids and Monsters video. This is the third entry in this particular series. I'm probably going to make around just two more for this series and maybe a mixtape, and then that way I'll let it rest for a couple of weeks thereafter. So please keep on with your suggestions. I'm still looking at them every single day, and then that way anything that catches my interest, I'll definitely talk about it here. So again, continuing the theme with regards to cryptids that are very large, the last one that I did, which was the Leviathan, could be considered the largest one of all, based on how large, of course, as an island Zeraton was. This one is not quite as large as those two previous cryptids, but considering that some reports suggest it to be the size of a lake itself, this particular cryptid is still quite massive. Not nowhere near as large as the Leviathan that could be considered up to 300 miles long, but it still is pretty large itself. And what I'm talking about here is with regards to a cryptid known as the Iceland Worm Monster. Its more traditional name is, this is a doozy of a name, but it's called the Lagarfljót Worm. Again, Lagarfljót Worm, which is the name of the actual lake itself. That's why it's named that way. But for the sake of this video and for the convenience factor, I'm just going to go ahead and go by its other moniker, which is the Iceland Worm Monster. And I'll be able to detail exactly what this cryptid is, where it's been sighted, what it looks like. It's interesting to note that all of these particular sightings have been pretty recent. I mean, this is a cryptid that has been around for several hundred years, but some of its most notable sightings were just in and around in this past couple of years up to the last maybe 25, 30 years or so. So it's pretty exciting stuff. Also, this is a very notable cryptid because there's actually been an organization that has looked at a video tied into this cryptid, and it has declared 100% officially that this video is real. So in essence, it's saying that the cryptid itself is real as well, that the information presented is genuine. Pretty fascinating stuff. This is the only time that I've heard of where a organization of sorts has all lobbied together and have been able to say, and this is like an official organization, some kind of commission, if you will, that have gotten together and said, based on the evidence presented, this is the actual proof that a cryptid is real. Pretty interesting stuff. So, now what is the Iceland Worm Monster? Well, you're looking at a picture of it here, which is from the video itself that I just talked about. This is pretty much the only purported known instance of actual evidence of this cryptid in action. I've included a link of the video below too, so what you're looking at is just a still shot. And again, the reason I can't post video links is because that's the quickest way to have anything as far as YouTube shut things down. It's strange, they don't mind photographs, but anything involving video or anything involving music like audio, that's it, you're done. So if you wanted to truly see the actual footage, just click on the link below. Feel free, I mean, if you wanted to pause this video and then watch the other one, or if you wanted to wait till afterward, that's, you know, it's your choice, but you'll be able to see exactly what I'm talking about. And when I saw this particular footage, it seems pretty lifelike. It seems like it's the real deal. So again, this is the only known footage, but I'll be showing some other artistic interpretations of what this worm monster looks like. Again, kind of like with the Leviathan, it's pretty much a free-for-all when it comes to people interpreting what this particular cryptid looks like. So no real theme, common theme, other than it's a worm-like object. But the Iceland Worm Monster is, of course, found in Iceland. That's hence the name of it. And it's a lake monster that has been around purportedly for hundreds and hundreds of years. In fact, the first known instance, you have to go way back in time, back to 1345. And this was sighted by the people there in and around an area there called the Atlantic Annals. back in 1345. And in fact, the people that saw this particular monster, this particular cryptid, took it as a fact that there was going to be a natural disaster happening soon. They saw it as a forewarning of sorts. Unfortunately, not much is kept in terms of records of this particular monster and those sightings during that time period. Instead, what has been kept as record is more along the lines of fables, if you will, tall tales of this particular cryptid. It's a little bit far-fetched, but it basically goes into the idea that this serpent, this worm, was created to guard a chest of gold, and that apparently a girl was somehow involved, and she broke open this chest, and so the serpent, whatever it was originally, was a tiny worm that grew into this massive creature in order to guard it. In other words, it's more along the lines again of what you would read on something involving your traditional tall tale story rather than the more scientific approach that you and I know of. So check that out when you have a chance. I won't really talk much into it because I don't know, I don't really put too much credence into that stuff. But you have to fast forward all the way into modern times in order to truly have a good sense of some of the experiences that people have had. And there have been multiple instances of people running into this particular creature. In fact, one of the more recent ones was back in 1998. There was a group of students and a teacher that came by and visited that lake. They were apparently from the school called Hallowmastier School, which is nearby that area. It's claimed to have been close to the river, in fact. And they were there, who knows if they were there on a field trip or if they were there just in between classes. Maybe they were even having some courses taught nearby that area. But they suddenly noticed that there was a mysterious, long, snake-like streak occurring in the river. And in fact, this was not just a simple instance. In fact, it lasted well over 10 minutes. And it's a shame, over 10 minutes, and again, this year being 1998, that nobody had a camera or nobody had anything involving a video camera, because even by that time, 1998, there were still plenty of disposable cameras, plenty of people that could easily have regular cameras in their possession. So again, why there was no footage with this particular instance, especially if it was over 10 minutes long, who knows? By the way, let's talk about the characteristics of this creature itself. Again, it's pretty loose when it comes to its interpretation, but the most common theme is that it's a worm-like creature. It is a very long creature. The idea is that either A, it's about 200 feet long, which to give you an idea is pretty much the size of, bigger than a football field. Your average standard football field that you and I watch every Sunday afternoon. So imagine a football field times two in length, and that's the size of this creature. Pretty massive, no? But that's not even the smallest size, the largest size of it. That's even, in fact, smaller than what you and I would think. The reported sightings are that sometimes it is actually as long as that lake itself. So that particular area, the lake there, measures around 19 miles long. And people have said that they have seen this creature measure from end to end that 19 miles long. I don't know how people can see 19 miles in the distance, but whoever did so and whoever said this, apparently this is what they go by. This is what they claim. So the idea is a worm here on Earth, a creature, not only is it massive, but it's very, very long. It's about 19 miles in length. Also, the other theme is that this creature, this worm, has many humps. Like you would think of, like, let's say your standard sea serpent, a snake-like sea serpent. Let's dispel this quick notion, though. It's not like other monsters that you and I know of that are on lakes, like the Loch Ness Monster, which is more like a dinosaur, like a, a Brachiosaurus or any of the other traditional type herbivore dinosaurs that quickly come to mind. No, this is more like a worm, more like a sea serpent. It's elongated, it's slim, it's massive though, and it's very long. So it's not like the other traditional Loch Ness monsters. That's why also why I did this video too, is because part of the reason why I don't do the Loch Ness monster or some of the other ones that are similar to the Loch Ness is because they're too boring. But this one is much like the Mongolian death worm, which was one of my earlier videos, my earliest ones. This one is more on the lines of a giant sea serpent and giant snake-like object. And those, I don't know, I just find more fascinating to talk about because, especially the size of this thing, if it goes up to 19 miles long, I mean, this is probably one of the largest cryptids in that area, not towards the world again, but at least in that area. So far more fascinating on that part. Now, another known sighting is apparently it just occurred just a couple of years back, and that's the one tied to this particular video, the one that shows the only evidence really of this creature, whatever it is, moving through it. This is the sighting that is pretty much the Hail Mary of the monster, of this worm itself. I mean, this is the holy grail of everything. And this is the one, the video that has been analyzed by a separate group to try to see, okay, let's take this footage, let's see what happens, let's analyze it, let's see if we can disprove it, and then see if we can, we'll just call it a hoax. If not, then maybe, who knows, we can at least claim that it's 100% real. And what this was it was footage that was taken in 2012, February. This was footage that actually went viral. I did recall actually seeing this when it came off a couple years back, but I kind of dispelled it. I don't recall paying too much attention to. I don't know why at the time, but it was something that I do recall hearing about it, but I didn't really pay too much attention to it. But there was a panel of 13 people just this year, 2014, that decided to review this information and try to see if they could disclaim it, if they could, you know, say, okay, it was debris, or it was the current, or it was something else within the sea that should not have been there, that is not the monster, but is still something else completely explainable. But no, this panel, whatever this panel was made of, whoever they were the ones that look at the panel, and then they realized, and these skeptics, I don't know if they were made up of scientists, I don't know if they were made up of anything involving, let's say, official officers from any kind of government institution. The only vague thing described on stuff that I was looking at was that this particular panel was just really just made up of a couple of people, and it was an expert panel that was created solely to judge if this video was genuine, and they decided that yes, it was. It is 100% genuine. So again, that's the closest thing, as I mentioned earlier in the video here, that this is the closest thing that one could have to having an official group of sorts state that footage given of an actual cryptid is real footage. That's pretty important to note, again, because with all the other footage that we've seen of other particular cryptids and stuff caught on film, from the Bigfoots to the Loch Nesses to some of the other bigger all-star type names, none of them, they really had something like this happen to them. Nobody was able before ever to really get into, let's say, a panel of sorts of experts, a panel of people that were in that field. I don't know, again, if they were scientists necessarily, but to get a panel together and to say that, yes, this was a particular cryptid, a real-life footage of it, that's pretty exciting stuff. So another notable instance is actually back in 1983, this wasn't panel-related, this wasn't, again, anything tied to any kind of footage, but I believe this is actually the most closest proof that we have, concrete proof, that yes, something is there in that lake, in that bed of sea, besides the footage that was you just saw there on YouTube. Because it's one thing to have, let's say, the YouTube footage, which doesn't really show much, but it shows something. But then you have something like this, which is pretty cool. It's some of the most compelling eyewitness and physical evidence given yet. Apparently, in 1983, there was a contract work done to have a group of men essentially extend cables, telephone cables, from one side of that lake to the other side of the lake. That way, those telephone cables could allow communications between both sides of the lakes. And part of the job involved having the cable cross a river. But instead of crossing over it, it would cross underneath it. And so this contracted group, they were led by a gentleman named Valdemar Benedictson, is his name. He was the one in charge to have this telephone cable placed on the bottom go through the bottom of that lake and then extend on the other side. And the way they did it was they used a particular cable that was made of a very thick steel wire that would do two things. One, it wouldn't break, and two, it wouldn't tangle itself, because the idea is, of course, this cable, that being the sensitive nature that it is, you could not have anything as far as the currents or any other type of activity cause that cable to again tangle or break. So they extended it, but while they were doing so, they noticed that while they were out in the lake and they were working on the cable, I guess they were on some kind of boat that they were using, and then they had probably some men underneath extending the cable at the same time. They noticed a strange thing. They noticed that there was a large, mysterious mass that was lying under a hollow bank of sorts towards one side of the lake. The way that he described it was the mass seemed to be organic and moved around as we performed the measurements. This was, again, a very large, mysterious mass. Those of you that had that phobia of, let's say, being in a body of water and then seeing something very large, massive, and dark underneath you moving around, this would easily have frightened the bejesus out of you. But the way he said was, they didn't really pay too much attention to that because they didn't really seem too threatening. There were nowhere flags that were jumping up. So they finished the job, and when they started to actually test the cable, they found that the cable wasn't working, that it was broken. And so what they did is they had to pull up the cable because they found the location. I guess they used some kind of a detector of sorts to have the known location of the exact place where the cable was not working. And so they had to pull it up. And when they did so, they were shocked to find out several things. One was that the cable was torn up in several parts. In fact, it was wound in several parts and badly torn in other parts. So here was a cable that was purposely built to not be wound up, to not be wrinkled up, and to not be torn, and yet it was done so in not just one, and not just two, not just five, but 22 different places altogether. How freaky is that? The guy there, again, the leader of that group, Valdemar, he was the one, I guess he must have known of the legend of this particular worm, because it's one thing about knowing about the legend and just discarding it, and it's another to have instant, let's say, proof that yes, something was doing damage to the very cable that they were trying to drag over the lake itself. And the way he said it was this cable was special engineered so it wouldn't kink, that was wound in several places, was now badly torn and damaged in 22 different places. I believe we dragged the cable directly over the belly of the beast, unless it was through its mouth. How freaky is that? So there they were working. There they were on a boat. There was this thing that potentially is, again, about 19 miles long. It was right directly underneath them. They noticed it. It probably noticed them. And yet they just continued to work. And then they suddenly realized that this very strong cable, again, made of some kind of very strong steel, was damaged, torn, bent, wound up in 22 different places. Shows the power that this particular worm, this particular monster, has. And again, I consider that one of the best eyewitness accounts with regards to this particular worm that was there, the work that they were doing there. So pretty fascinating stuff. So the Iceland Worm Monster. Has anyone else heard any other tales tied to this particular cryptid? If so, please post your comments, share them below. It's so fascinating to have something like this again be so recent. That footage, again, the one that's considered the Holy Grail, was just 2 years ago, and it does look pretty convincing. Some people have said that that footage is, again, debris that's moving towards the current or against the current, or it could be the, let's say, some ice or something along those lines, or it could even be something else, a school of fish, anything like that. But whatever it was, I don't know, it's something to see this in motion and realize, you know, that does not look like it's something fake. That looks like it's a real deal. That does not look like something else other than what you and I think it really is. So, Iceland Worm Monster, again, thank you for the suggestion and for watching this video. All right, folks, take care.